You know, the world of English is a fun, an exciting place to be. I'm so glad you could join me for another lesson.
Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope so. In today's lesson, I'm going to talk about a group of words which for many students can cause quite a lot of confusion. Yet they need not, as they exist in almost all forms of written and spoken language. In fact, I'm using them right now as I speak to you. In today's lesson, we are going to take a look at prepositions. A preposition is a word that helps us to construct and define meaning in a sentence. Prepositions are like the glue of a sentence. They formulate the relationship between certain words. They articulate. They help us define what we want to say. They help us to join words with meaning together. They are purely functional words, sometimes having no apparent definition. Yet without them, we would find it very hard to make ourselves understood. Prepositions usually come before nouns. However, they don't always follow or come after nouns. In English grammar, a determiner, such as the, can be placed between a preposition and a noun. Let us not forget that adjectives may also come between a preposition and a noun. On white horses. Up dark alleys. Over green hills. No matter how it is used in a sentence, a preposition never changes its form. Prepositions are mostly used singularly, on their own, in a sentence. They normally consist of six letters or less. There is also the two-word form of a prepositional clause, and a three-worded group as well. Prepositions are usually placed among other words within a sentence. However, sometimes they come at the very end of one, which some people object to. But now I'm getting a little ahead of myself. So, first of all, let's take a look at prepositions, beginning with the single ones. Aboard, about, above, absent, across, after, against, along, alongside, amid, amidst, among, amongst, an, around, as, aside, astride, at, atop, barring, before, behind, below, beneath, beside, besides, between, beyond, but, by, concerning, despite, down, during, except, excluding, failing, following, for, from, given, in, including, inside, into, like, minus, near, next, of, off, on, onto, opposite, out, outside, over, pace, past, plus, regarding, round, sans, save, since, than, through, throughout, till, times, to, toward, towards, under, underneath, unlike, until, up, upon, versus, via, with, within, without, worth. The overall description of a preposition defines the way in which a sentence is constructed. The general term for this is adposition. This type of word defines other formations, such as a postposition, which formulates the sentence after the noun. Postpositions exist in other languages, such as Japanese and Turkish. There is also the circumposition, where two defining parts appear on both sides of the dependent noun. Generally speaking, prepositions are the ones most commonly used, especially in English. Having said that, there are postpositions in English, such as ago, apart, aside, away, hence, on, and through. 10 years ago, this apart, such matters aside, 10 light years away, 5 years hence, 2 weeks on, the whole night through. Prepositions formed by two words. According to, ahead of, apart from, as for, as of, as per, as regards, aside from, because of, close to, due to, except for, far from, into, inside of, instead of, left of, near to, next to, on to, out from, out of, outside of, owing to, prior to, pursuant to, regardless of, right of, subsequent to, thanks to, that of, whereas. Another variation of preposition use is stranding. This is when a preposition occurs where it normally would not, yet still expresses a meaning. A good example is the sentence, "Who did you give it to?" This works because it is an interrogative sentence. The word "who" appears at the beginning of the sentence, so "to" can end the sentence, as it clearly refers to who. This form of sentence is most commonly found in English. Prepositions formed with three words. As far as well as, by means of, in accordance with, in addition to, in case of, in front of, in lieu of, in place of, in point of, in spite of. on account of, on behalf of, on top of, with regard to, with respect to. The use of prepositions at the end of a sentence has for many years been the subject of argument. Should a sentence be allowed to end with one? Despite the fact that there is no rule preventing a preposition ending a sentence, there are those who are against it being done. The earliest recorded objection to the use of prepositions at the end of sentences came in the 17th century by the poet John Dryden, who mistakenly likened the English language to Latin, which does not allow prepositions to end any sentence. Fortunately for us, this rule was never followed. So, if you want to ask, where do you come from? Or, where are you going to? You still can. Yes, it's the quiz show everybody loves to join in with. Spot the preposition. And here's your host, the guy who never takes no for an answer, George Spangles. Hi, how doody doody tip ta booty to you. Oh, it's great to be here again. Shall I do my catchphrase? Shall I do my catchphrase? It's nice not being dead. Not being dead, it's... Okay, it's great to be here with another edition of Spot the Preposition, where you, the viewer, has to spot the hidden prepositions within sentences. If you guess right, you will win this amazing star prize, which this week is... this beautiful stainless steel dining set, consisting of a fork and spoon. So, are you ready to play? It's time for our first Spot the Preposition. Here is today's first sentence.
Can you spot the preposition?
The cat sat behind the sofa. The cat sat behind the sofa.
Can you spot it? Quickly, quickly, quickly. Can you spot the preposition? It's hidden in there somewhere. Quickly, chop chop. Ding! Time's up!
The correct answer is... behind.
So, did you get it right? No? Ah, that's too bad. Maybe you'll have more luck with the next one.
They all stood at the bus stop. They all stood at the bus stop.
Can you spot the preposition? It's hidden in there somewhere. Ding! Time's up!
The correct answer is... at.
Did you get it right? Were you correct? If so, well done. And now, here comes our next Spot the Preposition.
I can tell you feel angry from the look on your face. I can tell you feel angry from the look on your face.
Quickly, quickly, the clock is ticking. Tick tock, 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 tick tock.
I can tell you feel angry from the look on your face.
Here comes the answer.
The correct answers are... from. On.
Did you get it right? I hope you did. Here comes our next Spot the Preposition.
I learn English throughout the day. I learn English throughout the day.
Here's the answer.
The correct answer is throughout.
So, how well did you do? Did you get it right?
Spot the preposition!
Prepositions, prepositions. Yes, you've got to have prepositions to make the sentence flow, to make it really go, to give it some jazz, to give it some pizzazz. You got to have prepositions. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Over the years, words used in English have changed and altered, and prepositions are no exception. A few of them have become obsolete during the last century. A couple of good examples being unto and twixt. The preposition clause allows sentences to be formed. They allow nouns to be used in an expressive way. They colour in the parts of a phrase which would otherwise sound disjointed and confusing. They define the placement of an object with something else, its position, its appearance, its movement, and its intention. It would be fair to describe prepositions as the building blocks of sentences. Without them, we would not be able to express clearly what we want to say. They hold the context of the sentence in place. They help to place actions with nouns, and nouns with other nouns. The most commonly used prepositions are of, to, in, for, with, and on.
I hope you have enjoyed today's lesson and that you have found it helpful. I will see you again very soon for another English class. Until then, this is Mr. Duncan in England saying thank you for watching me teaching you. And of course, ta-ta for now.